1 week to go to the US election. I'm on a plane tomorrow. I can't wait to meet Megyn Kelly. We'll do so for you next week. But in the meantime, we continue our chats weekly here on the telly. Megyn, the Super Bowl is just a week away.
Yeah, it's so bizarre and exciting and frustrating and nerve-wracking for many. I was saying on my show today, you know, I also have some worries about it. I definitely want it to go Trump's way. I've made that clear in the past. But I do think people should take a deep breath. Like, it's kind of amusing to me, I'm not going to lie, to see all the leftists absolutely melting down. Like, they're crying literally every day on MSNBC. They're crying, Paul. There's no crying in politics. Stop that. Grow up. Put your big girl and boy panties on and get through the next week or months. And we'll know eventually who won the race. And it could be Trump. Newsflash, Morning Joe. It could be Trump. I just think, like, I'm not one of those people who think the fate of the Republic depends on how this goes. It's definitely going to be a massive battle if Trump loses to maintain America as we know it. But I believe that we can fight that battle and we could win it even without the presidency. But it's always sort of a tell to see these leftists who just melt down over the wrong word choice here or there in like full emotional breakdown mode right now. And it definitely tells you that they are feeling what we're feeling, which is the momentum is with him.
Now, I think Trump had a spectacular event today. He was meeting with what are called angel mums, and these are the mums of people that have been killed by illegals in the country. The ad, I showed it a bit earlier in the day, was absolutely heart-wrenching. That and his economic message, well, that's what's going to win it for him, but what do you think he could do to lose it between now and then?
More stuff like the Madison Square Garden thing won't help. I don't know if that would make him lose it. I don't think what happened at MSG will make him lose it either. But, you know, to me, it reminded me of when I was in college and I dated the captain of the Syracuse lacrosse team, who was a great guy. And we went on a lot of dates, double dates with lacrosse players, great times. When the lacrosse team would get together and have a party, all 70 of them, like mostly the guys chilling out, having beers, whatever, I wanted nothing to do with that. That was too much for me as a woman. You know, a bunch of men all together drinking and having a great time and getting rowdy. I get it. There's a place for that. Most women would not want to be in the middle of it. And I had the same feeling watching that MSG rally. It, like, there is no place for me or women like me who don't like Kamala, but don't want to hear her referred to as the Antichrist and don't want to have her called out as a potential hooker. I mean, like, I don't like the woman. I don't like these kind of talk. Is this unnecessary? There's a lot of fertile ground if you want to mock Kamala Harris on the stuff she's actually running on or is. This stuff is just gratuitous and says something about you, the commentator. So that was a total fail, that strain of what happened at MSG and took away from what was in many ways a very great rally. Trump did great. It wasn't Trump this time. It was the people setting him up. So that was unfortunate. I don't know that that's going to make Trump lose. I think people have already kind of baked in their opinions at this point. You know, is it? And they're like, the left is like, people are protesting. Puerto Ricans are protesting. And they show the videotape. It's like five people standing outside of a Starbucks. I think we're good. But you don't want to do anything to hurt yourself in the last 7 days. So be careful. Like, now is the time to be perfect. And I think Trump's other message of, I will protect you. While some didn't respond well to it, I did, because a president does have that power in large measure. A president is the commander in chief. You know, a president can get us involved in international conflicts where my child has to go. Either one now, my boys or my girl. A president can help keep illegal immigrants off the streets of America. So that little girls like Jocelyn Ungaro do not get murdered in the middle of the night. And a president can encourage a stricter hand in law enforcement and encourage at the local level DAs who are not soft on crime, who actually put bad guys in jail and keep them there. It's not exactly a federal law enforcement matter, though it could be. So in all those ways, Trump can keep us safe. And that's, I think, what he's going with, because the left wants us to believe abortion, abortion, abortion. That's how women are going to die under Trump. And they're completely ignoring, you know, before my daughter or anybody's daughter gets to the point where, God forbid, they think about an abortion, we need to keep them safe. We need to get them to the age of majority. We need to get them through a robust and happy childhood. And allowing an open border, allowing soft on crime policies, DAs and so on, and laws doesn't help. I care much more about that than I do about what exactly will be the way in which my daughter could get an abortion when she's 30, you know, then. So I just think the Democrats have their priorities mixed up on that. And I think the average American, including my swing voter friends, you know, in the Midwest, will respond to what Trump's doing right now on safety.